So let's go ahead and set up the project this week. I'm going to start by creating a new project folder for week 9. And then in Notepad++, I'm going to save as week 9, and I'm going to call this 15.html. And I'll also create a new 15.css and 15.js. So those are my starter files. And then I'm going to do the usual. So doc type HTML, HTML head, title 15 puzzle. Exclamation point because it's so much fun. And then body and close body and close HTML. And then let me tab this over so it's properly indented. And then I'm going to add link rel is style sheet. href is 15.css and also script source is 15.js and close off the script tag. And then for my body, I'm just going to have a single div with the ID board. So that's going to be my game board, and all of the rest of the content of the board is going to get filled in by JavaScript. So I need to do one other thing here before I'm really ready to start, which is I need to install jQuery. And there's a couple of different ways to install jQuery. You can load it using an external URL, and there's some advantages to doing that, mainly that if you have a person who's browsing your site and a bunch of other sites, if you're all loading jQuery from the same place, well, there's a good chance they have it cached already, so they don't have to load it again. So that can make your page load a little faster. On the other hand, I sort of like to have it on my server so that if I need to make any changes to it, I can. Either way, I'm going to go ahead and open a new tab, and I'm going to search for jQuery. And the top link should be jQuery.com. So I'm going to go ahead and click on jQuery.com. And right on the home page, there's a link for downloading jQuery. So the current version is 3.1.1. So that's the one I'm going to go for. But everything we're going to be doing is going to be pretty vanilla jQuery. So should work for quite a while going forward. So if there's a later version, feel free to grab it. So I have some choices as to what I'm going to download. There's a compressed version, which is minified, and this is going to be a smaller download for your user. But if you need to debug it, you're not going to have the source code available. You're going to have it in a format that's really hard to look at and trace. So I prefer this uncompressed development version of jQuery when I'm doing development. And then when you're ready to release a finished product, go ahead and download the minified version and swap out which version you're loading in your HTML. There's also some slim versions that have various features removed, but I'm going to go ahead and download the full version for now. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the link, and that should go to my downloads folder. But actually, let me right-click on the link and save link as. And then I'm going to go to my C XAMPP htdocs CIS 133W week 9, and I'm going to save it right here at top level. So here's where it ended up in the same folder as my 15.js file and 15.html. So let me go ahead and copy the name here. And I'm also going to add, before my code, script source equals, paste in the name, slash script. So that's all I need to do to get jQuery. So let's see what happens if I reload this. I'm going to go to my week 9 folder and load 15.html. So the first thing jQuery does when you load it is it binds the variable $. So you may not realize it, but $ is a legal variable name in JavaScript. In fact, $ is a legal variable name character, so I can do mark $ as a variable name. Or I could say $$, mark $$ is another variable name. Or I can just create a variable named $, which is what jQuery does. And so if you go ahead and look at the value of $, you see it's a function and it takes some arguments. It takes a selector and a context. And we'll be looking at the selector in just a second. So if you read Eloquent JavaScript on the DOM, you probably saw a reference to a function called query selector, where you can say, for example, document.querySelector #body or board. So this is going to find the element on the page that has the ID board, that's what this # means, and it's going to return that. So there it is. Or you can also put a tag name here, like so, and you get back the body tag. Or if you have multiple tags that have the same name, like so, you get back the first one. Now, if you wanted to get all of them, there's query selector all, and that gives you an HTML collection that has both script tags in there. So this should be vaguely familiar. If not, go ahead and reread that part of Eloquent JavaScript. But the first thing jQuery does is it gives you a simple interface to that. So I can say $ open paren and pass in a selector argument. And it takes the same selector arguments that query selector does. And if I wanted to have a class, so for example, div class is tile1, div class is tile2. So here's a board with two tiles on it. I can use document.querySelector dot tile for the class. So there's the first one. Here's all of them. Same thing with jQuery. So that's the first functionality. You can use it instead of saying document.getElementById board. That's almost the same thing as this. Now you'll notice that here I'm actually not getting just an HTML entity or an HTML element. What I'm getting is actually a jQuery object. So if I say console.dir to look at this thing as an object, what I get is this jQuery function init object with one element in there, and then element sub zero, that's actually an HTML element. So what I'm getting back is a jQuery object that has a bunch of methods defined on it. Everything that's defined under this prototype. So add, add back, add class, after, a bunch of Ajax things, which we'll cover in 233W. There's an animate method, append, append to, adder, and so on. These are all jQuery methods, and we're going to be just scratching the surface in terms of what you can do in this class, but lots of stuff here. So the easiest way to think of jQuery is a library that wraps the same functionality we've been using in the course all through the term, and provides a simpler interface to it. So the first advantage is it's a little simpler to write the code for it. And the second advantage is that different browsers behave differently. So Chrome and Opera and Internet Explorer, I guess Microsoft Edge, Firefox, they all adhere to slightly different versions of the standard. And if you want to write JavaScript code that's going to work cross-browser, you have to know about all of those little idiosyncrasies. But the people who wrote jQuery knew about all of them, and they implemented jQuery in such a way as to provide good cross-browser support. So if you write the code yourself directly that manipulates the DOM and handles events, you're going to run into all sorts of weird cases that you need to know about. But if you use jQuery, a lot of that is hidden from you. You just call a higher level function, and it does the right thing on Edge or in Mozilla or whatever. So two big advantages to using jQuery, and it's been significant enough that jQuery is pretty close to an industry standard. I mean, a lot of sites use it, a lot of really big sites. So we're going to continue. Now that we have jQuery loaded, we can start working on our 15 puzzle.